Qigong. Qi, many people now have heard this word in Chinese language. It is part of, Qi is part of, it's in so much of their vocabulary. Da Qi is atmosphere. Tian Qi is our sky and weather. Pi Qi is our mood. You say Ta Mei Qi Le, oh, there's no more life. Someone has died. All different kinds of moods and atmospheres in a room can be described in qi. So it's a vitalized energy, and it's also information. Gong means to cultivate. So it's the cultivation of qi. It's very, very broad. And qigong works on three levels: energetic, our physical level, and also informational, or spiritual. Qigong is a path of self-development, of transformation. And most people come to Qigong to experience self-healing, to gain greater levels of physical health, which is what one does gain. And it is so much more, so much more. We look at even the physical, the energetic, and informational ways of development. We are given these beautiful vessels to experience life here on Earth. And through Qigong practice, we start to refine our sensitivity, our ability to absorb energy, to absorb information, and to transform any physical disharmony in our body and to build radiant health and vitality. So the lineage of Qigong that I refer to as my home lineage, Zhongyuan, Qigong, Zhongyuan means of the origin or of the source. And this form of Qigong has roots back 7,000 years, and it's steeped in Buddhism, Taoism, and Shamanism. Shamanism is so much about connecting with observing the power of animals, nature, and one of our most fundamental practices in ZY Qigong is Da Shu Gong, or big tree. Standing on the big tree, being a big tree. And other forms also, there's dragon and crane, it's from observing the power of nature. And like I said, most people come to Qigong for physical healing and well-being, and there's many, many thousands of forms of Qigong, and some are focused certain on specific meridians or on specific organs. ZY Qigong is a whole self-development system, so it's not focused on a particular organ or a particular form, and it's something, it's not exclusive. Whatever your religious or other practices are, you can incorporate within the body practices of ZY Qigong, and it is something that one can practice for a lifetime and continue developing as a soul in our human temple, refining our energy, refining and developing abilities that we all have innately as humans. I'm going to go into some whomping, and this is, so shaking, it both awakens, it enlivens our body, our energetic body, our physical body. It shakes up any stagnant qi. It also shakes out qi, so it can go out of our hands, out of our feet, so we can receive new qi. And thought patterns, emotions, we can get stored in our body and our organs, and shaking is an organic way just to shake things out. And our body has its own wisdom to get back into balance. It's also an organic way for your, encourage your body for the energy to flow in what's called the microcosmic orbit, which is energy coming up the due meridian, up the spine, and then down the red meridian, down the front. It goes around this, and that helps balance out our hormones. And there's the Dai channel, the belt channel. So if you feel some stuckness in here, you know, you might find, just find your body, or moving your hips around more. That can help. So even if shaking is just your practice,
It is an extremely powerful practice, and you'll experience many health benefits and other benefits.
In Qigong, we talk about the dantians, whereas in yoga, they talk about chakras. Qigong emphasizes three main energy centers, the lower dantian, which is when we're bringing in energy, we bring it into our navel, and then our dantian, it varies on a person, but it's inside and often a couple inches below the navel. But we bring energy into the navel, and then we imagine it stored in our lower abdomen. Then there's the middle dantian, which is in the heart center, and the upper dantian is also known as the third eye. And these energy centers are something we're born with the potential for developing them. And it's through practice that we cultivate Qigong, cultivate energy, cultivate these centers. And we begin with the lower dantian. And many spiritual traditions, it all begins with, it's our root power, it's our root grounding, it's our connection with earth, which also connects us with sky. And it's this grounding from here that we store this energy that then will rise and open up other abilities and in our development as a soul as well. So it all always comes back to our lower dantian. And in ZY Qigong level one, we focus on the lower dantian, also on relaxation. And it's in this deep, relaxed state that transformation begins to happen. One of the treasures, the offerings of ZY Qigong as a lineage is in all ever, from the beginning, starting with level one, all the way up into the highest levels, as well as the medicine that comes from this tradition, we work with image. Image is the basis of life, even before language. And in our training, medicine this lineage offers is called image medicine. And, Kate has offered a paper she wrote on it here. And our grandmaster has opened an institute in China using image medicine for doing research and on all sorts of different diseases and conditions. And it's last year was named the top medicine in China. It's a form, it's a branch of Chinese medicine that was cut out because doctors became too powerful. But the government was afraid the doctors would be viewed as gods, and is now being reintroduced, and through ties with the government and with other universities, Mingtang's able to bring that forth now. But I'm just mentioning that, in these practices, particularly the main meditations, one is Big Tree. I mentioned Da Shu Gong, where you actually stand as a tree, and you hold the image of being a tree until you become a tree and learn from trees. It's similar to the stemming from the shamanic roots of learning from other life forms and receiving information. That's another form of qi, comes through information. And it's the language of spirit. It's the language of all life. Animals, plants, they talk to us also through image. And in medicine, it's a way of diagnosis, of seeing the root cause of the problem, whether it be informational, whether it be energetic, whether it be physical. And then when one's image is powerful enough, like our grandmaster and several students, Kate practices this image, it's shh. Our master says, oh, shh, you changed the image. It's in the simplified explanation of image medicine, but it comes down to changing an image, and we all innately know a healthy image. We see a tree, we know there can be many signs of disease, but we know the one image of health. Even if we've never seen this type of tree before, we know which one's healthy. It's something we know. Mm-hmm.